Welcome back, everyone. I'm Stephen Harrell, Tiny House Listings, and today I thought I'd share a quick little tip, a little app that I discovered that I think is kind of interesting, and it's just one of many tools you could use to save money. And the reason I'm doing this video is because I know a lot of you are actually trying to save money this year to buy a tiny house. And the problem is, I know with a lot of tiny houses, you have to have a hefty down payment, if not pay the full price of a tiny house. So the cost of entry is a bit steep for someone, especially when you're talking about $40,000, $50,000 homes, sometimes less, sometimes more. It can seem like you're kind of standing at the bottom of a mountain looking straight up, especially if you're in debt. But the reason, one good thing I think you can use this app for is to not only save money, but figure out money that you didn't have available for to pay off debt and save money.
The name of the app is called Tip Yourself, and it's a neat little app. It's very simple the way it works. They have a social aspect to it, so you can see what other people are doing. But the gist of it is, each time you save money, for example, here's some things I did recently. I skipped breakfast and cooked out instead. I was going to do that. I tipped myself 10 bucks. I saved $250 on, I was able to talk the price down on a piece of software that we use for tiny house listings to the people who run the business. So I took that money and saved it. I bought cheap wine instead of expensive wine, saved $5. I went grocery shopping at a grocery store, which I highly recommend, called Aldi. If you have one in your area, you can save a ton of money. And here's some, once again, wine at Trader Joe's, $2.99. Made chili at home instead of going out to dinner. Saved money by grocery, joint, anything. It goes on and on and on. But the idea is, each time that you save, each time that you do something to save money, you just kind of go in and put the amount and then put what it was for. And it literally does a bank draft from your account into these guys' account.
The reason I like this little app, and there's tons of other financial apps too that you can use it. If you guys like these types of videos where I can recommend an app or give you ideas on how to save, let me know in the comments below, or just do a thumbs up and I'll get an idea. Thumbs up versus thumbs down, whether or not this is the type of thing you like. But I like this because you can do it right on the spot. You don't have to log into your bank account, do a transfer. And a lot of banks, actually, if you do a certain amount of transfers, they charge you a fee. If you do from checking to savings or something like that, some ridiculous thing. But you can do a milestone. So once you hit the milestone, you can withdraw the funds back into your checking account, which I know sounds a little counterintuitive. But then you can take that money and withdraw it and put it somewhere else, get cash out, put it in an envelope, something. But a lot of people might say, well, you're not getting interest when it's in this Tip Yourself account as opposed to being in your checking account. But truth be told, most major banks, some credit unions do, but most major banks these days offer essentially zero interest. So for example, you could say the first quarter of 2019, I want to save $3,000 or whatever it is towards my tiny house fund. So that you can find out if you're on track. 2 months in, you should hopefully be $2,000 or $1,000, whatever is your budget we'll set you at. And then you can withdraw it, take that money, put it in whatever you want to do with it. Give it to a family member, to trust, I don't know, whatever works best for you. But I like this because you can save money right there on the fly. And for me, at least, it's allowed me to get creative. Like for the example, the other night, some friends invited me to go have drinks and dinner with them. And I didn't want to miss out, so I whipped myself up a quick dinner before I left. And then went and had a couple drinks with those guys. So I went and had dinner with those people, and I saved, I don't know, 15, 20 bucks. So I went in to Tip Yourself, and I did that money. And it adds up really, really quickly, a lot quicker than you thought. There's the stereotypical way to save, rob yourself of a $5 coffee a day, those types of things. And the funny thing about it is, these amount of monies that you save are normally, very rarely, big things. But for example, the other day, I haven't done it yet in here, but I was told the muffler on my car needed to be replaced, right? It was 700 bucks, and I got under the car, did just a little bit of finagling, and sure enough, it was just a couple bolts that were loose. And I did like a little quick $1 fix to get that. So $700 saved. And the reason I've been going through, looking at these types of apps is because, one, I want to figure out ways to help you guys save money so you can move into a tiny house, whether that's buying one or building one yourself, because I truly believe in the beauty and the merits of living in a tiny house. And another is, I'm pretty guilty myself of squandering money in small amounts that add up to be large amounts. So this right here is proof. Right here, you can open up an app and literally see how much money you've saved just by being a little bit extra frugal, right? And a lot of people say, well, I just don't have the extra money. Maybe you truly don't, but for the vast majority of people, and the reason I can say this with confidence is I see people doing it who say they don't have money and they engage in these types of activities where they're just squandering money, just pissing it away. So if you like these types of videos, let me know. I have a couple financial apps that I've been experimenting with, and some of them are very, very good and actually impressive. It's almost like the 2019 way to bank. So if you like these types of quick little, you know, tip videos, because I am giving you guys one video every day this year, which is great because it's had my creative juices flowing, and I hope you guys are liking them. But let me know in the comments or give me a thumbs up or whatnot. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.